Coffee mood boosting effects confirmed. You probably are already aware of the mood boosting effects of coffee, but I can confirm from trying it again in several weeks that coffee does have a mood boosting effect. It actually does make you feel a little bit more upbeat. Not only that, it gives you additional clarity. Obviously, that's due to the caffeine, but I think there's something else to that that works in combination and gives it a little bit of an extra kick, takes it to the next level, if you will. Coffee, I can honestly say, is something that I would recommend in moderation to feel just a little bit better on those days when you need it. Now, keep in mind that everyone's sensitivity to caffeine and coffee is gonna vary from individual to individual, but a big part of that has to do with how often you consume it. I've gone a few weeks without consuming any coffee and very minimal caffeine, just a diet soda or two a day, which actually is less than I normally consume. And I can tell you that the effect of the coffee and the caffeine that it contains is somewhat amplified so that you don't have to have multiple cups of coffee to get the same benefits. But keep in mind, in order for you to get that benefit, you can't drink it too often. Otherwise, you'll build up a tolerance, and that's not something that you want, because you're gonna have to drink more and more quantity of caffeine in order to achieve the same level of euphoric feeling, clarity, and mood boosting effect. Just in case you're wondering, the main difference between the coffee that I have right here, which is a cafe Americano from Starbucks, and your typical regular coffee that you might get, is that this is a coffee that contains caffeine in the form of an espresso shot, and other types of coffee just are made with regular ground coffee. There could be a difference, I don't know, I'm not sure, but in case you want to replicate the effect that I got with this coffee, if you don't drink coffee too often, this is the one that I got. And yes, black coffee with regular ground coffee beans does contain more caffeine than espresso, in case you're wondering, but the difference is not that much, especially if you compare them pound for pound. Espresso is just a little bit different in taste, in my opinion, and I do enjoy it a lot, much more than I do the regular coffee, but your mileage may vary on that. But yes, if you want the highest dose of caffeine, black coffee edges out espresso just by a little bit. Generally speaking, coffee of all types contain a healthy amount of essential nutrients, including a lot of antioxidants, which is sometimes, at least in some studies, have shown to be more potent than in some fruits and vegetables. I don't know how true that is, but it's nice to know that you're getting some health benefit with this coffee. In comparison to soda, the caffeine and nutritional content of coffee is still superior, because typical sodas are generally not going to have as much caffeine content per volume as coffee. Also, with the soda, you're missing out on the other nutritional benefits, such as the increased antioxidants and the variety of other essential nutrients. But keep in mind, with the soda, you're also getting a built-in sweet taste. I, by the way, usually get diet soda, and this saves me a ton of sugar. But if you're the kind of person that does not like the taste of diet soda or zero sugar beverages, then soda could be probably something that you won't want to have because of the extra sugar. But coffee does not have any sugar, so this is the one to go with if you're looking to lose weight, watch your calorie intake, and generally just enjoy all of the health benefits. And you also have the flexibility of sweetening the coffee a little bit in moderation with a little bit of sugar or artificial sweeteners, of which there are a great variety out there. So definitely, I would say coffee is, generally speaking, the healthier choice. However, I do still like sodas, and this is an example of why. The variety of actual flavors and formulation is enormous. In the market, you're gonna find different types of sodas ranging from diet and these zero sugar varieties, which I think taste pretty good, and you should give it a shot if you don't like the taste of diet sodas. The zero sugar is a little bit of a twist on the flavor. They kind of played around with it, and you might like this one. Plus, you get the benefit of the zero sugars, very low calories or no calories. So it's healthy from that standpoint. And again, different flavors. These are available in Coca-Cola, Pepsi, Dr. Pepper. A bunch of sodas are adopting the zero sugar, and even some of the diet sodas from some of the other brands might be something that you might find more palatable than some others. So definitely don't rule sodas out. It's good to have, and because they don't contain as much caffeine as coffee, this is something that you might want to consider. But what about if you actually do want more caffeine in your soda? Well, you're in luck, because a lot of caffeinated beverages, I would put this in the category of a soda. This Monster Energy Zero Sugar, again, very low calories, if any at all, you still get the benefit of nutrients that are infused into this drink, such as antioxidants and other nutrients, beta carotene, etc. But you get a healthy amount of caffeine compared to regular soda. Typically speaking, these energy drinks do contain significantly more caffeine than regular soda. I personally don't want too much caffeine, so I found that this particular Monster Energy Zero Sugar is one of the lowest caffeine contents out there in the energy space. But the other energy drinks that are out there do contain higher amounts, as much as double what this contains. This is only about 160 milligrams of caffeine, and in the entire can, and other companies do market, including Monster, market other energy drinks that contain almost double that, if not more than double the caffeine. So just be aware of that if you're overly sensitive or you just want to consume caffeine in relative moderation. Monster is a pretty good drink. I'm fond of it. And again, you get a lot of the benefits of coffee, but you can have this cold. It's in a can and it's available everywhere, not just your coffee shops. And by the way, an honorable mention to this Rockstar energy drink that I actually do enjoy as well. I've recently been consuming these about one every couple of days, and they do contain vitamins, minerals, and again, same thing like the Monster. This particular one is low calorie, zero sugar, and it actually is labeled as sugar-free right on the can. It does contain a minimal amount of calories, 25 calories, but the main thing is it does have caffeine, so you're still gonna get some effect of caffeine, but it's a small amount compared to other energy drinks. Like I said, 160 milligrams of caffeine is not that much by comparison to other energy drinks that can contain upwards of 300. So definitely consider this an option as well. It has a unique taste, so your mileage may vary how you like it, but I actually have built a taste around that. It is an acquired taste, but I think it's worth a try. Now, this is a disclaimer that I have to make in a lot of my videos where I talk about any kind of a beverage that is not water, and that is that water is the best way to hydrate and to stay healthy. It's the cleanest if you want to avoid any type of chemicals. Water is the best. There's nothing addictive about it, and it's gonna be your best bet, your go-to for hydration. Don't drink coffee for hydration because of the caffeine content. You don't wanna overdo it with this. But again, coffee does contain a lot of water depending on how you make it, so it could, in theory, be good for hydration. Just don't drink coffee that has a high concentration of caffeine, because that kind of defeats the purpose of being hydrated, because caffeine does have kind of a slight diuretic effect, which means that it dehydrates you and causes your body to release fluids, and that's the opposite of what you want in something that's gonna hydrate you. Now, another thing about caffeine, in my opinion, a lot of the stuff in the news and in the past about bad things happening in people that drink coffee, and that has to do with the concentrated dosages of coffee that people take. And caffeine in powdered concentrated form, that is a recipe for danger, because the caffeine is concentrated and you're taking a combination of a relatively large dose of caffeine, and it's concentrated without a lot of liquid and fluid being consumed with it. But again, in moderation, as with anything else, if you drink caffeine responsibly, you shouldn't have a problem. The main thing you gotta worry about is avoid those pills that have caffeine or those powdered supplements that contain caffeine, because it's gonna be concentrated and it's not gonna be diluted in water. And I think that's where you're gonna have the problem. So guys, hopefully you got something out of this video. Stay safe out there, and I will see you in the next one.